Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject fluid mechanics and machines. This is lecture number 2.3. We are going to solve problem in the pressure measurement. In the earlier two lectures, we discussed the theory part of the pressure measurement, Pascal's law, hydrostatics law. We defined atmospheric pressure, gauge pressure, absolute pressure, vacuum pressure, and we discussed the theory part of various pressure measuring instrument like manometer and mechanical gauges. So in this lecture, we will be solving problem on pressure measurement from the Anna University question paper. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the pressure measurement. Example number 1. The right limb of a U-tube manometer containing mercury is open to atmosphere, while the left limb is connected to the pipe in which the fluid of specific gravity 0.9 is flowing. The center of the pipe is 12 cm below the level of mercury on the right limb. Find the pressure of the fluid in the pipe if the difference in mercury level in the two limbs is 20 cm. So the given data, specific gravity of the oil is 0.9, and this is the diagrammatic representation of the problem. So this is the pipeline in which oil is flowing and it is connected to the U-tube manometer. So the center of the pipe on the right limb, the mercury level is 12 cm above the center of the pipe, and the difference in mercury level between the left and the right limb is 20 cm. X-axis is the reference point or the datum point. So we are given the specific gravity of the oil. So to calculate the density of the oil, specific gravity into 1000 equals 900 kilogram per meter cube, and density of mercury is 13600 kilograms per meter cube. The height of the oil in the left limb above XX, so the XX is the datum level, so the height of the oil 20 minus 12, so 0.2 minus 0.12 equal to 0.08 meter. So the height H1 is from the center up to this point, it is H1, which is 0.2 minus 0.18 equal to 0.08 meter. And height of mercury in the right limb above XX is 0.2 meter. So mercury level is 0.2 meter. So pressure of the oil in the pipeline, so P equal to rho 2 GH2 minus rho 1 GH1. So 13600 into 9.81 into 0.2 minus 900 into 9.81 into 0.08 equal to 25,977 newtons per meter square. So the pressure of the oil in the pipeline is 25,977 newtons per meter square. Example number 2. Again, a U-tube manometer containing mercury was used to find the negative pressure in the pipe containing water. The right limb was open to the atmosphere. Find the vacuum pressure in the pipe. The difference of the mercury level in the two limbs is 100 millimeter, and the height of water in the left limb from the center of the pipeline found to be 40 millimeter. So this is the diagrammatic representation of the problem. So the water is flowing through the pipeline. So the pressure here is negative pressure. So that is why we find the mercury level in the completely on the left side with reference to the datum point XX. So the height H2 is given as 100 millimeter, so which is 0.1 meter. H1 is 40 millimeter, which is 0.04 meter. And density of water is 1000 kilograms per meter cube, and density of mercury is 13600 kilograms per meter cube. And the pressure in the pipeline. So right limb, it is completely above the XX. In the right limb, there is no fluid. So we have pressure acting only on the left limb. So the various pressure acting on the left limb equal to pressure of the fluid, pressure of the water inside the pipeline plus rho GH2 plus rho GH1 equal to 0, because on the right side there is no pressure. So rearranging, pressure in the pipeline equal to minus of rho 2 GH2 plus rho 1 GH1. So substituting numerical value is 13600, rho 2 is the density of mercury, rho 2 13600 into 9.81 into 0.1. plus 1000 into 9.81 into 0.04, the answer is minus of 13,734 newtons per meter square. So the pressure in the water, pressure of water in the pipeline is negative pressure, 13,734 newtons per meter square. And this question was from the May 2006 question paper. The next example number 3 from November 2009 question paper, a simple manometer, U-tube manometer containing mercury is connected to a pipe in which an oil of specific gravity 0.8 is flowing. The pressure in pipe is vacuum. The other end of the manometer is open to the atmosphere. Find the vacuum pressure in the pipe if the difference in the mercury level in the two limbs is 250 millimeter and height of the oil on the left limb from the center of the pipeline is 150 millimeter below. So this is the diagrammatic representation of the problem. So we have the oil flowing in the pipeline. H1 is the height of the oil column from the center of the pipe up to the mercury level, and H2 is the difference in mercury level between the right and the left limb. XX is the datum or reference point. So in the problem, it is given H1 equal to 150 millimeter, which is 0.15 meter, H2 equal to 250 millimeter, which is 0.25 meter. Density of the oil. So we are given the specific gravity 0.8. So density equal to 0.8 into 1000, which is 800 kilograms per meter cube. Density of mercury, which is constant, 13,600 kilograms per meter cube. So pressure of the oil in the pipeline. So we write the pressure equation. So in the left side, left limb only the pressure is acting. Right side there is no pressure acting above the XX reference point. So P plus rho 2 GH2 plus P1 rho 1 GH1 equal to 0. Rearranging P pressure in the pipeline of the oil, which is minus of rho 2 GH2 plus rho 1 GH1. Substitute numerical value is 13,600 into 9.81 into 0.25 plus 800 into 9.81 into 0.15. So this is 34,531.2 newtons per meter square minus, it is negative pressure. 34,531.2 newtons per meter square. Example number 4. A single column vertical manometer is connected to a pipe containing oil of specific gravity 0.9. The area of the reservoir is 80 times the area of the manometer tube. The reservoir contains mercury of specific gravity 13.6. The level of mercury in the reservoir is at a height of 30 cm below the center of the pipe, and difference in the mercury level in the reservoir and the right limb is 50 cm. Find the pressure in the pipe. So specific gravity of the oil 0.9, area of the reservoir capital A is 80 times of the small a. Small a is the area of the pipe. H1 is 30 cm, H2 is 50 cm. Specific gravity of mercury is 13.6. So density of the oil, specific gravity into 1000, 900 kilogram per meter cube, and density of the mercury, rho 2 equal to 13,600 kilogram per meter cube. And this is the diagram. So we have a pipeline. So this is connected to the manometer. So the reservoir is, this is the reservoir and this is the tube. So the height of center of the pipeline up to the reservoir, the height is H1, which is 30 centimeter. From the datum reference point, the mercury level on the tube is 50 centimeter, and the area of A is the area of the reservoir and small a is the area of the pipe. So pressure of the oil in the pipe, P equal to AH2 divided by capital A. Small a is the area of the pipe, capital A is the area of the reservoir, rho 2 G minus rho 1 G plus rho 2 GH2 minus rho 1 GH1. Now, substituting numerical values, H2 equal to 0.5, small a by capital A equal to 80, 1 by 80, so 80, capital A by small a equal to 80, 13,600 and 9.81 minus 900 into 9.81 plus 13,600 9.81 into 0.5, rho 2 GH2 minus rho 1 900 into 9.81 into 0.3. So the answer is, pressure in the pipeline is 64,384.387 kilonewtons per meter square. Example number 5. A pipe contains an oil of specific gravity 0.8. A differential manometer is connected to the point A and B of the pipe, so shows the difference in mercury level of 20 cm. Find the difference in the pressure between the two points. So, the specific gravity of the oil is 0.8, difference in the mercury level H equal to 20 centimeter. Density of mercury rho g equal to 13,600 kilograms per meter cube, and the density of the oil rho L equal to, specific gravity is given as 0.8, so rho L equal to 800 kilograms per meter cube. So the difference in pressure between the point A and B, PA minus PB equal to rho GH into rho G minus rho L, or a differential mercury manometer. So 9.81 into 0.2 into 13600 minus 800 equal to 25.11 kilonewtons per meter square. So for differential manometer, it is very simple to calculate the pressure. A pipe containing water at 180 kilonewtons per meter square pressure is connected to a differential gauge to another pipe of 1.6 meter lower than the first pipe and containing water at a high pressure. If the differential height of the two mercury column of the gauge is equal to 90 millimeter, what is the pressure in the lower pipe? So this is from May 2014 question paper. So P1 is given as 180 kilometers per meter square, H mercury column, height of the mercury column is 90 millimeter. We know density of water is 1000 kilograms per meter cube, density of mercury is 13600 kilograms per meter cube. Difference in pressure is given by P2 minus P1 equal to GH into rho G minus rho. Rho G is the density of gauge fluid and rho is the density of water. So P2 minus 180 into 10 power 3 equal to 9.81 into 0.09. So 13600 minus 1000. So P2 minus 180 into 10 power 3 equal to 11.124 into 10 power 3. So rearranging the pressure in the lower pipe, the higher pressure, the pressure is high on the lower side. So P2 equal to 191.12 into 10 power 3 newtons per meter square, or 191.12 kilonewtons per meter square. Example number 7, two pipes A and B connected to a U-tube manometer containing mercury 13600 kilograms per meter cube. The pipe A carries a liquid of density 1250 kilograms per meter cube. Liquid density 800 kilograms per meter cube flow through the pipe B. The center of the pipe A is 80 millimeter above the center of the pipe B. The difference in mercury level, so you can refer to this diagram, the difference of mercury level in the manometer is 200 millimeter. The mercury surface on the pipe A side is 100 millimeter below its center. Find the difference in pressure between the two connected points of the pipe. So this is from November 2010 question paper. So this is pipe A and this is pipe B. So the mercury is the manometric fluid. In the pipe A, there is fluid flowing with a density of 1250 kilograms per meter cube. And in the pipe B, the density of the liquid is 800 kilograms per meter cube. And the mercury, density of mercury is 13600 kilograms per meter cube. And the mercury level in the left side, pipe A, is 100 millimeter below from the center of the pipe. And difference in mercury level is 200 millimeter. And from the center of the pipe, the distance between the two centers is 80 millimeter. So we are given density of manometer liquid rho G equal to 13600 kilograms per meter cube, density of the fluid in the pipe A rho 1 equal to 1250 kilograms per meter cube, density of the fluid in the pipe B rho 2 equal to 800 kilograms per meter cube. So pressure in the left limb above XX, so rho GH of mercury plus rho GH of the fluid A into PA. So rho GH of mercury 13600 and 9.81 and the H equal to 0.2. Plus rho GH of A side fluid 1250 into 9.81 into 0.1 plus PA. Simplifying, PA plus 27909.45, so we call this is equation number 1. We take the diagram once again. So the difference between the XX and the center of the pipeline, so the XX and the center of the pipeline B, it is 200 plus 100 minus 80 equal to 220 millimeter, which is 0.22 meter. Now in the pressure pipe B, so the pressure acting on the pipe B from the above the datum XX, rho GHB plus PB. So rho GHB equal to 800 into 9.81 into 0.22 plus PB. So simplifying, 1726.56 plus PB. So we call this is equation number 2. Now equating these two equations 1 and 2, so from equation 1 and 2, the difference in pressure on the two sides, PA plus 27909.45 equal to 1726.56 into P plus PB. So PB minus PA equal to 27,909.45 minus 1,726.56 equal to 26,183 newtons per meter square. Example number 8. An inverted differential manometer is connected to two pipes A and B containing water is shown in the figure. The fluid in the manometer is oil of specific gravity 0.8. So, this is the inverted tube manometer. We have the manometer fluid, oil of specific gravity 0.8. For the manometer reading shown in the figure, so the readings are diagrammatically represented. Find the difference in pressure head between A and B. So, read the diagram. So, this is the center of the pipe A. So, we take this is the datum point. So, the height of the water in the A pipe A is 100 centimeter, and this is the center of the pipe B. So, for the pipe B, the mercury, the level from the center up to the mercury level is 50 centimeter, and oil level is 50 centimeter, and the difference in the manometric fluid, difference in the oil height equal to 30 centimeter. So, we are given specific gravity of the oil equal to 0.8. We know the density of the oil. From the specific gravity, we calculate the density. Density of the oil is 800 kilograms per meter cube, and density of the water is, we know, 1000 kilograms per meter cube. So, the pressure below the datum of the left limb. So, this is the datum below the datum for the left limb. So, PA, pressure in the pipe A minus rho GH of water. So, PA minus 1000 into 9.81, H equal to 100 centimeter, which is 1 meter. So, PA minus 9810, this is equation number 1, we call it as equation number 1. We take the diagram once again for reference. Now, the pressure below the datum for the right limb, B, PB minus rho GH of oil minus rho GH of water. Rho GH of oil 800 into 9.81 into 0.3, rho GH of water 1000 into 9.81 into 0.5. So, simplifying PB minus 7259.4. So, we take this is equation number 2. Now, equating 1 and 2, the difference of pressure is PA equal PA minus 9810 equal to PB minus 7259.4. So, PA minus PB equal to 9810 minus 7259.4 equal to 2550.6 newtons per meter square. So, difference in pressure equal to 2550.6 newtons per meter square. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering. You may find the Fluid Mechanics book. For additional problems in the pressure measurement, you can refer to the book. There are number of problems available with the proper solution procedure. Also, I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel. Use the videos for your better learning. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comment box. You subscribe the channel. You can contact me for any clarification on the subject through my mail ID or WhatsApp number. So, we will meet again in another video lecture in the Fluid Mechanics. Until then, bye bye.